Welcome you to the manufacturing facility of Triad American Machine Company, located here in Alden, Nebraska. Today we have for you is the TSR. TSR is a template stair router, template on the top. I'm going to go through some of the features and the benefits of this machine to you, a customer. What do they mean to you? What can this machine do for you? I'll actually go through the controls, show you this, some of the operations, and actually run some material so you can clock me on the screen itself as things go through. Now, the TSR was originally, we came up with this as a complementary machine for our stair line. We have a CNC stair machine called the SSR, Smart Stair Router. We have a stair clamp, and we also have a wedge machine. Cranks out wedges for you on a regular basis. This is a complementary machine. The TSR was developed to specifically go after the used stair market. There's a lot of guys out there. It's priced accordingly. The other thing is, it's electrically maintenance-free. What does that mean? It means there's no computers. It means there's no computer updates or anything of that nature, okay? Maintenance free on electrical. It's real simple, easy to run. I'm going to go through how you'd actually set something up, pull a template down, show you. I've got one off the side here, how all the features and benefits work to you. Okay, first thing we're going to do is I'm going to go through the controls over here for you. The template stair router, left hand side, we'll try and zoom in here for you. On the template stair router, you're going to have pull it on or off, okay? Once you pull it on, light comes on, we've got power. Shut it down, light goes off. Okay, as soon as you pull it on, air's activated. The router heads themselves actually engage and come to the up position and stroke up. Okay, the next light over is a red lamp, and it's an overload light, indicating we have an overload situation. Check your manual, explain how to take care of that. We also have a switch. We can turn the top router off or turn it on. Likewise with the bottom router, on or off. Next thing, the black button we have is a clamp button. If I hit clamp, we're actually coming in, clamping against the fence first, and then we're coming down against the working surface. Both the horizontal and vertical cylinders are coming in. I hit unclamp, which is the yellow button. Okay, next thing that we have the green button on the lower left-hand side is going to be routers down, which will actually turn the routers on and it'll stroke in the upward direction for both routers. And the last button is the red one, which actually shuts the MOS's router up. Okay, so if I hit the green button, the routers also engage into the working surface where you need them into position, and the red button actually shuts them off. Okay, real quickly, the TSR comes standard. You can have an in-feed roller conveyor on the left-hand side, in-feed conveyor over here, the mainframe itself, and you have an out-feed conveyor comes standard with the machine. You, the customer, you need to provide to us a couple of quick things. Number one, we're going to need a transit from you so we can go ahead and level and shoot this machine in and a hammer drill. There's leveling feed assemblies. There's going to be four of them total that come on the mainframe leg assemblies. It's one down here. There'll also be a wrench. Installer comes, sets this all up. He anchors this to your floor as well as the in-feed and the out-feed conveyors. Okay, in a nutshell, the conveyors help the overall process of the material pass through the machine. And hit clamp up, deactivate them. What we're trying to do is keep all the working surface up above the main frame bed area of the machine. So everything's rolling on the rollers, moves nice and easy, real fast. That's what we need. I'm actually going to go through here, show you a couple things. On the template, we take an ordinary framing square, okay? You can buy this anywhere. You guys can buy them in any one of your towns. And we have a trammel. We have these two different trammel points. You've got two wrenches that come with the machine. Pulling off here. And the trammel points are quickly adjustable. You can move them just about anywhere you'd like. Whatever's required. In this case, I'm going to put it at 11. There's a little line on here. Hopefully we can see this in a shot. Probably not. There's a little white line on the trammel. Line it all up. Cinch it down. And this one I'm going to go ahead and set at, I'm going to set it at 9. Framing square actually comes with a machine with the travel points on it. I'm going to start talking about the template. You say, well, what am I going to do with this? The beauty of this machine is you don't have to figure out the hypotenuse. All you need to know, what is the rise and the run? Once again, you don't have to figure the hypotenuse. We don't have to advance the scale down here, or some funky scales up here. You're trying to look on this side, and then you come over and look on this side, and then you try and transfer the information down to some of the lower machines that are out there. That's not required. It's not necessary anymore. If you want to set this up, in my case, I said 9 and 11, I'm actually going to set my treble. So I've got my treble points. Try and get in here on the camera if we can, best we possibly can. And what I'm trying to get accomplished here is I take the treble point, put it against this working surface and on the back side. Now what I need to do is just line this front portion up so it's flush. I've got a yellow handle here. All I have to do is break it, loosen it up, and this whole assembly slides back and forth. Okay? And you can actually run through the entire range. The entire range is required. Okay? And you don't even have to change a template to get the entire range, whatever the hypotenuse may end up being, as long as you're running 9 and 11, you don't have to change a template. You don't have to change the template unless you're actually going to change the material. If you're going to change your tread thickness or your riser thickness, then you need a different template. Okay? All right, so real quick, we'll try and come in here with a camera. As you can see, I've actually taken this quite a ways out of range. All I have to do is dial it back in. And what I'm trying to do is get it flush. It's pretty easy to tell flush, guys. Just run it with your finger and you're saying, well, there I am. Everything's going to be in place. Lock down the handwheel casting. Get it nice and secure. Now, I've got all that accomplished. Now I'm going to take that same information, since I don't have to worry about the hypotenuse, I'm going to set a stop, take my treble. I've actually got a short step and a longer step on the treble. I take the longer side, I engage it in a stop hole that I have. I've got a stop bracket. One of the first things that I'm going to do is I'm going to initiate the clamp, lock everything in place. I have a cylinder locking mechanism down here, so I'm going to take my feed mechanism and I'm going to lock it in place so it doesn't budge, doesn't move, okay? Then all I do is I loosen my stop. I've actually got two series of holes, one on the stop assembly itself and another on the main member of the frame that's welded to the frame. So all I have to do is locate the two holes, put my treble in it. The hypotenuse is done, guys. Nobody in the office has to figure it out. Guys generally on the floor struggle with that quite a bit. When you're all said and done, put the framing square up and we're ready to start running. Totally calibrated, guys. That's it. Dirt simple. That's the whole idea behind it. Once again, template changes. I'll explain this one more time later on in the film. But the benefit to you, you don't have to change template as you're trying to get through the range. That's great. That's probably one of the best things about this machine. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and clamp, get some material out of the way. I'm going to bring the arm in for you, trying to give you some idea. We're running with routers top and bottom. We're engaging them. I'll try and get a close-up here on the inside if we possibly can. What I actually have is a turret stop. It's a rotating turret stop. Try and get this back over here a little bit more. Okay, the turret stop, the longer one is set up for 2x material like we're running now. It's 2x material. The next one is actually set up for 5/4. And the next one is for 3/4. Those are infinitely adjustable. I know 5/4 isn't worldwide standard, the same across the nation. So that's why it's infinitely adjustable, gentlemen.